Hello. It's time for another book haul, and this is one of my favorite book hauls yet because I have just some of the sweetest, kindest human beings in my life who have gifted me with so many wonderful books this month. And it was perfect timing because I was getting down in the dumps a little bit for part of the month, and some of my friends sent me some books that was so sweet and kind of them. And let's talk about those books today. As you can see, I'm still rocking the chipmunk cheek wisdom tooth extraction face. So 13 books were sent to me by you guys, which is so thoughtful and generous. And I'm just always blown away by the generosity of the people in my life. And I'm so thankful for it. And then I purchased 8 of these books on my own. So that is 21 books I'm hauling for the month of March. But I don't feel bad about it because I bought less than half of them. And I believe all of the ones I purchased are already read. And some of the ones that were gifted to me are already read. There are 8 manga and 1 novel in this book haul that I have not read yet. So let's get into the gifts first. First, Christine, thank you so much for sending me the 7 volumes of A Silent Voice, which is one of my favorite anime movies I've ever seen. It was so impactful and something I constantly want to return to. Now I'm already a good portion of the way through the first volume, and I just want to take my time with it because I know I won't want it to end, but I love this so much and I am so thrilled to own this for my collection now because of how much this story means to me. And I love the movie so much and I'm so thankful to now have the manga. Christine also sent me Uzumaki by Junji Ito. It says Spiral into Horror. These hardcovers are just freaking stunning. And if you have never read horror manga, I highly recommend picking up Junji Ito because he is phenomenal. The artwork is so creepy, but the stories are really gripping too. Oh, there's even some color mixed in throughout a little bit. So I love horror manga. I found out last October that it's one of my favorite things, and I can't wait to pick this up because there's definitely so much hype surrounding it, and I'm gonna wait until I'm in the mood to be creeped out, but I know this will do the job because so many people are freaked out by this horror manga and I just can't wait to pick it up. And look how beautiful this edition is. So it says spirals. This town is contaminated with spirals. A small fog-bound town on the coast of Japan is cursed. Their town is haunted, not by a person or a being, but a pattern. Uzumaki, the spiral, the hypnotic secret shape of the world. This bizarre masterpiece of horror manga fall into a whirlpool of terror. Sounds interesting. I forgot to mention, but I should also say, this manga series follows a girl who is severely bullied because she is deaf and is not able to hear. And the relationship between the two characters, the one doing the bullying and Shoko, our main character, who is the sweetest, purest, most kind girl in the whole entire world, and how they try to mend that relationship and how bullying is so harmful and the consequences of it. Another book that Seth sent me is Star Wars The Dark Lord Trilogy. We have Labyrinth of Evil, Revenge of the Sith, and Dark Lord The Rise of Darth Vader. Revenge of the Sith is like my favorite movie, so I am beyond excited to get to this. So it's by James Luceno, except for Revenge of the Sith is by Matthew Stover, based on the story by George Lucas. So I love Star Wars. I love reading Star Wars novels. I've only read the newer canon Star Wars novels, so I'm excited to dive into some of the older stuff that's now part of the Legends or the movie adaptations, because I've never read one of the movie adaptations either. But I am always here for more, especially Vader content. So this is right up my alley, being the Dark Lord trilogy. I just think it's gonna be such a great time. I kind of want to listen to the audiobooks while I'm reading it, because I think that will make for a fantastic reading experience. So thank you so much to Seth and Christine. Then my dear, sweet, beautiful, wonderful friend Alwyn gifted me with this set, and I am just like beyond grateful. And I never imagined in a million years someone would send me all of these books, because honestly, it's pretty pricey to purchase all of them, and with building a house, I couldn't justify it. And now my heart is so happy because I have these additions to match the new book that just came out. And that is all of the hardcovers for the A Court of Thorns and Roses series by Sarah J. Maas. So we have A Court of Thorns and Roses, this beautiful like coral color, A Court of Mist and Fury, and this beautiful teal color. A Court of Wings and Ruin in this like pink, hot pink fuchsia color that is just stunning. And A Court of Frost and Starlight in this gorgeous blue, because of course the new A Court of Silver Flames is orange. So this collection, I could not be more thrilled to have. I think the spines are stunning. I am so on board with the cover change now after I saw A Court of Silver Flames and had it in my hands. I love the cover changes. I love the bright, vibrant covers. It feels much more adult to me. And to be honest, I was never that big of a fan of the people on the first covers anyways, or the spines. So I'm thrilled. I feel like I don't deserve this. You are so sweet. Love you, girl. Thank you for sending this to me. And I just feel like so undeserving from all of you guys. And thank you so much. Getting into the books I purchased myself, we have this unfortunate edition of Dune Messiah, which I actually purchased a couple months back. And then I missed my window of return. So I guess I'm just going to be buying these now. And this is the sequel to Dune by Frank Herbert, which you guys know I'm obsessed with this. And it's tricky. So if you're ordering on Amazon, God forbid, make sure you check out the dimensions of the size you're ordering. Because if you click paperback and you don't check the dimensions, it's going to be the skinny mass market. But now I have it and it's okay. I also finally picked up Kingdom of the Wicked by Carrie Maniscalco, which is the first book. And I think it's going to be a duology, but I read this earlier this year and reviewed it. And it's a young adult fantasy novel that I really enjoyed, with like this Italian setting and princes of hell. Really cool magic. I love Carrie Maniscalco's romances and her strong female protagonist. So I wanted to have this for my collection. And it was sold out of stock for the longest time. So I'm glad I was able to get my hands on a hardcover copy. I then picked up Piranesi by Susanna Clarke, and this is a stunning book. It's a very strange size book though, as you can see it's super wide, but even the end papers are gorgeous, and it has really stunning naked hardback and spine. I just like the details in the small things that make something really beautiful, but I will link my review, my spoiler-free review for this, because it's 5 out of 5 stars, and I think everyone, no, not everyone should read this, because a lot of people aren't going to like it, but I wish everyone loved it, because I think it's phenomenal. Then I picked up All the Murmuring Bones by A.G. Slatter, and I'm really surprised this is already a paperback. I guess a hardcover didn't come out, but this came out in March, and that's when I read it, and I really loved this, like, gothic adult fantasy novel with some horror elements, as this girl is fighting for her agency and basically trying to live the life she wants versus what her family wants for her, rather than being married off to some person that is abusive and she does not love, and being trapped into that life. So she's trying to take her power back, and the gothic and horror elements were just enough to be creepy and add that much to the story. I loved it so much. I'll link my review so you can hear me talk more about it, but I really needed to own this copy. I also picked up Nemesis Games, which I read in the month of March. And this is by James S.A. Corey, the fifth book in the Expanse series. I guess we are just going to go with the names on the spine now instead of the title. Why? Why though? I love these covers. I love every single one. They're so epic and detailed and beautiful. And I'm just really excited to own this copy, because this has been my favorite installment in the series so far, I believe. I really enjoyed my time reading every second of this. And in fact, I kind of drug out the reading of it because I didn't want it to end. So I can't wait to continue on. I can't wait to own all 9 of these books on my shelf. And they're beautiful to look at, but they're excellent to read as well. Then one of my favorite purchases for this month is Lady Hotspur by Tessa Gretton. How stunning is this? This is a Henry V retelling full of prophecy, ghosts, and betrayal, and queer folks who have to balance their own desires with the good of the world. I want every detail. I'm hungry for every word. And I feel like that really sums it up. It says, if you're interested in reading about kick-ass warrior knight ladies, then this is a book for you. The dragon will burn, the lion will break, and the wolf will choose the end. And it's not for everyone, but if you read and enjoyed The Queens of Innistlier, which you do need to read before reading this, I think that you will enjoy this as well. And this is a fantastic cover change from the original cover, which I was hesitant to purchase. And this is just stunning. And it's one of those really nice floppy paperbacks. And I'm so happy to have this on my shelf. Even though, like, there's nothing really special about the spine, the cover's where it's at. She's a thick girl. We're down to my 2 favorite purchases of the month. And that is this paperback of House of Chains, which is just beautiful and stunning and wonderful and glorious. You guys know my hunt of finding Molasses and Book of the Fallen paperbacks in this large format, and I found this for a great deal, and I'm so happy about it because this is my favorite book in the series so far, and I want to own all of the paperbacks in this size. So I'm so happy to own this for my shelf. I love this cover. I love this artist. Todd Lockwood, I'm so devastated that he didn't do the art for books 9 and 10, but I at least want to collect all of the ones that he did do the work for. And last but not least, the one I used my main credit for the month is Toll the Hounds by Steven Erikson, book 8 in the Molasses and Book of the Fallen series. I love this cover as well. One more Todd Lockwood cover, and I obviously bought this one used because it's very yellowed. It's a huge floppy paperback. It's beautiful. I believe it was a library copy, and it is a first edition, so I'm very thankful to have this and add it to my Molasses trade paperback shelf. And these books are just so precious to me for how much I love this story, and I want that represented in the books on my shelf. As trivial as that is, I'm so excited to own this. And now I just need to purchase books 9 and 10 with the new cover, which will be a shame. But there you have it. Those are all of the books that I acquired in the month of March. Let me know which ones are your favorite of the ones I picked up. What books did you pick up in the month of March? I would love to hear. And thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart to everyone who sent me a book this month. That was so generous of you, and I am very grateful and appreciative, and it does not go unnoticed. So thank you again. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.